everybody! This is a little game called Loadout, which I've been streaming a little bit, and so I decided to make a Let's Play of it, just to show you guys what it is. And it's basically kind of like in the style of Team Fortress 2 in some ways, other ways not. And I guess I'll show it off to you guys. So the entire premise of the game is that you have a really complicated weapon crafting system. So, you know, like I can get my sniper rifle out and you can see like I have a long-range scope, a sniper barrel, semi-automatic trigger. So I can change it to like maybe a two-round burst sniper rifle or like a full auto. Well, it wouldn't really be a sniper rifle, but I can name it whatever I want. Like, it's just, it doesn't matter. So it's kind of like the customization action of the game, aspect of the game. You basically pick a base, it's either like a rifle, which is like bullets, launcher for rockets, pulse, which is like big blue balls, and beam, which is kind of like a, kind of like the lightning gun, I guess, from Quake, or like Unreal has something similar as well, the link gun. Kind of like that. So it's very old style. You can kind of like these old style shooter weapons, which really I like, because you can kind of like make any kind of weapon you want, which is a really cool aspect of this game, and I think it's really well done in that way. And then you have loadouts, so I basically, you know, I have sniping and not sniping. Railgun is still sniping, but whatever. And so, everything that you can purchase in the game, in terms of like weapon attachments, stuff like that, it has to be done by in-game. The in-game, from playing games, basically, the that kind of currency. So it's called bloots or whatever. And the only way you can pay to get more of this is by speeding it up, by like getting a booster. And the rate of which you get it is actually fairly quick. So it's not like a kind of like a pay to win model or anything. The coins though is how they make you buy basically cosmetic items. And so if I go to my outfitter, you can see like the characters. There's this person. You can go put on panties and go make her twerk. This is the worst thing I've ever seen. Okay, that's enough of that. No, toss that, fuck that. And so you also have a level progression system as well, and avatars you can kind of like fuck around with and unlock. These cost money, or you get like apparently level unlocks and things like that, so you get it like some of the time. So it's pretty interesting stuff what you can do with this. And then there's a whole tech tree. So there's also a progression system to basically, you know, at the next level I get 2 points on strength. So literally what like upgrades do in this game is just basically, and as I said, it's not something you can pay for outright. So there isn't someone who spent $50 and gotten all this shit already. No, they've been playing the game and all that kind of stuff. So yeah, it basically works like that. So it's kind of interesting stuff. So let's go play casual versus humans and find a match. It shouldn't take that long. And so this game doesn't actually allow you to host your own servers. It's a very much a, hey, there you go. That was quick because I'm by myself. It doesn't let you host your own servers. They're trying to have some kind of private server system, as far as I know. And at the beginning, you have this weird thing where you're actually going to kill everyone. It's basically the person with the biggest splash weapon wins. Oh, it's run away. And what kind of game mode are we playing? We're playing Capture the Hammer right now. So that's a... Oh. Apparently I'm on their side, and I shouldn't be doing that. And so this game, it has multiple game types. This game mode, this game, and this one's a particularly, it's a capture the flag variant where you run around with a basically a jackhammer. You can kill people with it in melee range. And I have a rocket launcher as a secondary weapon, and I'm about to die. But I'm good now. So I basically use as my primary kind of loadout. I have a sniping variant. And I basically run around and just kind of headshot people. It is difficult in this game, much like some of the older style shooters like Unreal Tournament and things like that. There is a headshot mechanic, and you can even get a sniper attachment to get... There you go, I headshotted that guy, I think. There's even like a sniper attachment to do more headshot damage. I have not tried that one. I got basically the normal one because I headshot about 20% of the time, 10% maybe. It is hard when people are like moving around like this. But that makes it fun. That makes it more fun, you know. I don't mind a challenging game to snipe in. See if we can go get this guy. And this guy got set on fire. Oh, he took the hammer. You could also melee as well. And I got hammered by that guy. So that's kind of what happens. It's quite honestly, it's kind of like a fucking mess of a game. I won't lie. I do like it, but it's got a lot of problems, and the problems are mostly in the with respect to spam. I'm not saying though that this should be like a everyone has a sniper rifle and runs around with one. No. But I think the emphasis is really high on the because of the fast movement and all that. The emphasis is really super high on basically running around. Okay, someone got him. But the emphasis is really high on spam weapons. So anything that fires a lot of bullets and things like that is that's why I kind of have a rocket launcher secondary. It makes no sense. The enemy has dropped the and I got his hammer. You have returned the hammer. So by the way, every 100 points I spend. Oh. Sorry, I get 100 points for killing everybody, and so 500 on top of the 500 I get for bringing the hammer back. So it's kind of a nice thing that you can, you know, you get even more points when you're returning the hammer. Anyways, so a lot of the game types are basically very close range. The enemy has stolen the hammer. Damn it. Your team has taken the hammer. You basically are way better off. Oh. Boy. The emphasis is very high on the spam. The people with the best rocket launchers are basically the people who are doing the best. And so they're trying to change that right now. I think it's a common complaint to the game. And there's a lot of balance issues, especially regarding some of the attachments and things like that. Like, everything should be balanced, but it's really not. Oh. There you go, I got him. Oh wow, now I'm dead. And that's what I mean, you see right there, it's just kinda like, it's the spam will win every day of the week. So let's try the not sniping loadout. So this is, I tried basically running around with a railgun. And that's basically the best I could do for that. It's not a very good loadout. It really isn't. I really thought that this is basically a laser gun with like a sniper attachment and like low heating and all that kind of stuff. So it's basically a railgun. Like the benefit of using something like this is you never have to reload it. But it doesn't do a lot of damage. As you can see, I'm just getting smoked from long range. I did kill that guy though. And this is kind of the reason I actually don't run around with this. There's like a lot of, like, the thing is you don't really know what's a bad loadout until you get to try it. The enemy has dropped the hammer. You have returned it kind of really sucks when I would think that things would be balanced, but they're really not. Like, you just can't know until you try it. And honestly, like as I said, I didn't spend a whole lot into rocket launchers. And I feel like I really missed out on that, you know, because it's the rocket launchers, some of the game modes, I swear, are like, they're very close range oriented. See, I didn't even do that much damage to that guy. I got the hammer here. Oh, look at this guy. Successful hammer kill. Your hammer value has increased. Honestly, I would say that like, the only way to play sniper in this is to play a very mobile sniper. This is the only game mode where this works at all. A lot of them are really close range. Okay, we got it. Another cap for me.
The enemy has stolen the hammer.
And like a lot of things really feel And yeah, that has range on it. A lot of things just feel really, really shitty on the load. It's like it's one of those things. They're working on the balance. Damn it, I missed horribly there. I know.
The enemy has dropped the hammer.
All right, now we're gonna go. Oh no, someone's gonna get it.
The enemy has stolen the hammer. The enemy has dropped the.
And he ran kind of back at us. What?
Enemy has dropped the hammer. You have returned the. Your team has taken the hammer.
So I have a bit of machine gun, and I don't know. I'm just showing you different things. You can't actually change it out. I thought I'd give you a bit of variety. But yeah. So some of the game types are like there's a deathmatch kind of a game type.
The enemy has stolen the.
Also, there's a lot of scope sway with this. I'm gonna just go run and get this health back. There's a lot of scope sway with this weapon here. So even this guy, you can see he's trying to get me with it. Oh, what? Okay, so apparently I switched my weapon. I don't know at what point I did that. I think I pressed the mouse wheel by accident. That happens. That's my mouse. It's not the game. Some of the game types, like almost all of them have an emphasis on huddling close, and you have to basically use rocket launchers to essentially. What do I do? I have to reload it. And that's what I mean. Like you miss a lot because things are moving around very fast. I don't know. It's one of those things. But like, there's a game type where you have to kind of capture the flag. Guess what? You're all on a single point, so it's like not great. I've had grenades this whole time, but I haven't really been using them. Forgot I had this kind of a setup. So, like, as I said, once again, the spam, you know. There's really no reason for me not to do that. Oh, I reload it. So the guy's just waiting there. Jeez. No health at all. And once again, there he goes. Is even on this mode, the rocket launcher seemed very powerful. And so, like anything else, is kind of like not too great. And just kind of trying to help my friend over there. There's one where like there's even a deathmatch mode. In the deathmatch mode, you have to pick up vials. It's kind of like I think there's like some sort of kill confirmed game type in Call of Duty. It's exactly like that. So using something that's long range is a really bad idea. So like this guy was trying to snipe me, but like I wasn't even moving that much.
The enemy has dropped. You have returned the hammer. You are victorious.
And we win.
Your team has captured the hammer.
That's what I mean. So everything's close range. So if you're just like sniping from far away, it's bad. So you have to play kind of in a marksman kind of a way. And I don't know what I think about that per se. It's just yeah. It's as I said, everything's up close, and you have to specifically gear kind of your character for that. So look, I get a daily prize. I still find it to be really fun, though. I really do enjoy this game. It's cool. And so this is like the end. So you only get points, obviously, if you actually win a match. So that's me getting a bunch of stuff. So I'm going to actually go switch out my loadout a little bit, and we'll try something a little bit different in terms of weapons. Okay, so I've tried to modify two weapons a little bit. I'm actually going to use a beam weapon here. Because I actually did really like these when I started it, when I started playing it. It was one of my favorites. And then I'm trying a pulse sniper. I'm trying to build this guy up, and I still need like a lot of points to get. There's a bolt action on like a fucking laser. The big ball gun. That's the one of the things that Padkiss was actually telling me to try, and I haven't yet gotten the currency for that. Okay, so I ended up kind of finding another match because. We did another jackhammer match, and sorry, fuck that noise. We've already done that. We're not doing that again. Honestly, I think it's Well, that's actually an interesting game type. That's not bad. There isn't much in terms of bad game types here. Now, unfortunately, I'm probably going to lose this thing right here. Because I have no explosive weapons. There you go. But it seems so pointless. I don't know what the idea behind that was. This is my little beam weapon. Okay, and I have like sticky balls. Seems really pointless. Because now they're actually projectiles. Oh, I actually got him. So this is us being on a point, and you're gonna notice that there's a lot of people just kind of like just sniping us out. Let me get this health back right here. They can't get me now. So the control points keep changing on this game mode, and we basically just gotta run to each one and go get it. So I've noticed that especially on any game mode. Oh, there we go. So, as you can see, everybody uses machine guns or rocket launchers kind of thing. It is, I think, that one of the banes of the game. It makes it very uninteresting. Like, I even have, like, grenades because I feel if I don't, I feel I'm at a huge disadvantage. Well, someone just sniped me there, so good for him. But this is one of my least favorite game types because of the fact you're forced onto one point to cap. So, like, everybody has the same kind of thing. And this game mode especially suffers from huge problems with regards to, yeah, I can't even hit that guy because of the projectiles. And I'm just gonna get killed here. This is what I mean, and you know what? Since I made that weapon, and it's in a loadout, there's nothing I can do about it. It stuck with me for this game unless I decide to quit. Unless I take this guy's sniper rifle. Nope. Unfortunately, he killed me. I was already weakened. So I could just change the... Okay, I did not change the next... I didn't change my other loadout, which is my sniper one. With the rockets, because... Yeah, because fuck everything else. So this one I had mostly as a... Like, the beam weapon is kind of cool. It really is. Also, I'm totally not going in the right way. I'm just following this douchebag. We're totally going to lose to them. That's what I mean. Sometimes you just feel like you can't...
A control point has been lost. The enemy has scored. They are now in the lead.
There's just so much crap going on right now. And there you go. I've got... This guy doesn't even have a very fast sniper rifle. Let's go to my sniper setup, because I can kick this guy's ass. I just don't have a proper thing. And I know I started my underwear. Oh, what? Oh, what? You want to fucking fry me a little bit? Come here. You know, I'm not even helping our team, and we're apparently getting a point.
Captured. The score is now tied.
And once again, the emphasis, you see, I'm using a sniper rifle. How effective do you really think it's going to be on a game mode where we're supposed to be standing on a point? The answer is not really. I can snipe people off the point, potentially. But good luck with that. I thought this guy was shooting at me. Damn it. And also to contest a point. Fucking, are you serious? Oh, wait. No, I don't have any. I forgot I don't have grenades on this loadout. Kind of see why I have this now, because it's stupid how much spam there is on the middle points. I really needed health back. I'm gonna go over here and not get one because it's not there. But I'm just gonna die to the first person who comes here. The guy actually shot down all my rockets and is continuing to do so, and I guess that's the end of that one. So this one isn't even, like, it's not even a test of skill, it's not anything, it's just basically just a giant clusterfuck.
You have lost a control point.
Like, one of my least favorite ones. And it's good I'm showing it off to you, because you got to be prepared for this kind of stuff. You know, some people might like the kind of hectic gameplay where you're desperately trying to get points. For me, it's not really anything I like because it's just like, get people on it, get people off of it. And there you go. With the rocket launcher, I got them all off of it. Kind of snipe people when they're trying to get onto it. But they all are equipped to deal with it. Every single one of them, I can guarantee you. And you see what I mean about the spam? Like, this guy is just jumping around and using some Tesla gun. And I can't melee him, I can't rocket him. Well, the rockets are my best option against him. But it is, I guess, more of a close range issue than anything. But every single person has some sort of spam weapon in this. Like, if you don't have one, then you're actually at a huge disadvantage, I feel. Like, I don't know if you can tell what's going on, but I can't. I certainly fucking can. And honestly, the biggest problem this game, I would say, is the lack of, like, it doesn't explain very well what you died by. It doesn't do very good job, because the thing is, there's so many combinations of weapons. So, you know, I get killed by some guy with, like, a Modar launcher. I'm like, oh, shit, what did he have to fucking have that? I kind of want that, have that, too. I can even pick up his weapon, and I would never fucking know what it is. I simply can't know. And I think that's the most irritating part, because I want to know this kind of stuff. I want to know what they have on their weapons. What kind of ridiculous, overpowered pieces of shit that they managed to create. And, I missed his head. So, like, here I can try to snipe, but I'm not going to be very good. I'm trying to melee because I have to reload this. And see, this guy's just, he's not even doing anything, he's just kind of like standing there and just chucking grenades at me, so. As I said, my least favorite game type, and the thing is, you don't really have much control over this stuff. Like, I can't just go into like a matchmaking queue that doesn't have this game mode. No, you're gonna be playing this sometimes. It's just something you're gonna have to put up with. And that's it. It's just an absolute clusterfuck. I have to get on the point, and sometimes it's just like, it's whatever. There are people who are just such pieces of shit with this. Like, I've seen people who, there are some really bad loadouts that require, like, some serious changes. I'll give you some examples. You can get a healing, you can make healing bullets. So you can make, you know, a beam weapon? You can make that into, like, you saw me, anything that you see me using, I can make it so that the ammunition doesn't hurt me. It instead heals me and other people around me. And so apparently what they've done is they've made it so that it doesn't heal you for as much. But I've had really bad games where they've basically gone and there's a guy with a healing rocket launcher. And basically what he did was he instead ran... When basically he wasn't around his team and we would have got a score on him in a deathmatch mode, he'd basically run around healing himself and running back to his team. And then, so that he had basically a rocket launcher for healing himself on one hand, and on his other hand he had one for killing everything. So like he had a spam weapon and another spam weapon to heal himself, and that was, I think, one of the worst things I've ever seen in this game. And I got really frustrated about that game because it's just like the one time that we should have been able to get the kill, we couldn't. And so you basically just spend your time running around. It's as I said, this is actually probably one of the worst examples of just absolute... We've been on the same point for fucking an hour and a half. And I think you can see right here the amount of ridiculous spam projectiles here. Like, and that's what I mean. Like, I think if you're going to be effective at this game, you're going to have one loadout with nothing but grenades. Absolutely nothing but just projectiles and grenades, just so you can switch between weapons. Because look at this guy, he's not even going near the point. I can't move off of it if I want to cap it. That's just the way it works. And we're going to be stuck here for quite a long time. Because I'm not aiming it either, because I know they're going to be back. Like, I'm not exactly helping the situation. But what do you want me to do? Like, right now, like, I'm on this point by myself, and that's, like, I'm done. Like, so they do it to me, I do it to them, and it's just like, yeah. So I really hope that what they do is they address some of these issues, these game types. I want them to be better. But there, like, the rocket launcher has a lot of options there. Like, this guy, he doesn't even notice I'm here. Because everyone's just so focused on the point. I wish my team would really get on this right now. So that guy has, like, a really, really high splash damage and high damage rocket launcher. Once again, it doesn't communicate to me exactly what they're using, so I don't know what the hell they have. But I could just tell by the fact that it does a lot of damage. That it was, like, a lot of... It was just ridiculous. So now I'm back on the point. And there's two people on the red team just spamming the point. And that's it for me. So, it's not like I can't avoid this kind of gameplay. I'm just stuck with it. And I'm honestly starting to get fed up with it because I'm bored out of my mind right now with this. And this is the one reason I wouldn't actually, like... Yeah, I'm gonna get the point. Go get the point. I'm not gonna kill you. Nope. Okay, fine. You just fucking come right up to me. That's fine. I kind of now just want this to end. I'm gonna just show you guys the. Fucking, it's not gonna end. And that's the thing. You can just grenade everybody to get them off the point. Oh my god, we got it. The score is now tied. You should have fucking taken the point when I let you. Should have done that.
New controller point activated.
And I'm dead again. I don't know. So, you know, if there's one game reason I wouldn't recommend this game, it's because of this game mode. And as I said, if they do a better job in balancing it, then, you know, then it works for me. And I don't think it'd take a lot. It's just certain things I think need to get. I think, honestly, any kind of healing weapon should not heal yourself. It should just heal teammates. I think that's one of the things I would do. And just communicating to the player why you died, you know? I don't mind dying. I like the premise of it, though, and the base is there. They have the game type. They have, it's all here, you know, it just needs a bit more work. And they'll have it.
You have captured a control point. One capture remains.
And now we're all about to die. Oh, I made it out. I'm a survivor.
New controller point activated.
Fortunately, I can't get a health pack. It's difficult to tell where they spawn from, though. It's interesting though when people have healing rocket launchers and they can, like, it's the healing is based upon the damage, and obviously rocket launchers do a lot of damage. So, well, there you go. That's the end, and I don't think I feel I need to show you anything else. Just, you know, it's worth a try, and you may not have the same complaints I do, and it may. Apparently, this guy really hates the shields, but the grenades I feel are actually better, especially in this kind of game type. I don't feel it made the difference. I really don't. But yeah, I think that's it for this, and I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you later. Take care, everybody.